Good morning, Cattle Market News. Shaylee Stewart here with your Cattle Market News tip sheet brought to you in part by DTN. Here to do what we always do and get you caught up in the cattle market. And I'm excited to tell you that we are finally in 2022. We're going to get back to the market. We're going to get back to some normalcy. I don't know about you, but that time in between Christmas and the New Year just always throws me for a loop. And so I'm excited to be into 2022 fully and to just get back to some normalcy, hopefully, in this marketplace, in our world, and in our country. But before we talk about the markets aren't anything without people, without this industry, without the community of agriculturalists, ranchers, and farmers that comprise it. And so, you know what? When one of ours is hurting, we need to take care of them. And so, you know what? I'm thankful that you guys tune in and support these videos, but one of our very own needs your support now. And I know that so many of you know her voice. You've come to absolutely cherish every time she tunes into Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, wherever you listen to her reports at, but that's Miss Mackenzie Johnson. And I hope that you take a time. I hope that you take the time to reach out to her. I hope that you take the time to love her, and I hope that you take the time to just simply pray for her. She had a viral infection that led to Bell's palsy, and so right now she's not doing her market reports, and she needs to know that you are anxiously cheering her on, that you're encouraging her, and that you cannot wait until she gives her next report, because it's going to be the best yet. So nevertheless, whenever one of our own is hurting, we take care of them. And so Mackenzie, just know that we're praying for you and that we love you and that we can't wait till you give your next report. So until you get back, we're going to keep on rocking this ship and keeping the boat afloat until you get back and you can fill in the details. So nevertheless, folks, let's get you caught up on your last week's market. Starting at the top of the report, as we always do with your Friday to Friday livestock contract changes. February live cattle throughout the week last week gained 8 cents. April live cattle gained 90 cents. And listen to what this feeder cattle market did, ladies and gentlemen. January feeder cattle gained $3.43 and March feeder cattle gained $6.20. Let's dive right on into that fat cattle trade, because it just might surprise you, and hopefully we say this all throughout 2022. But last week the trade developed mostly on Tuesday and Wednesday. We saw a little bit of cleanup trade on Thursday, and then there was some cleanup trade on Friday. But I am so proud of those southern feedlots. They just really stuck their heels in the ground, and even though come late last week they ended up taking $1.38, they waited and they made packers wait until Thursday and Friday to trade cattle, and they weren't going to take their week's early offerings. And so they really socked it to them, and even though they didn't quite get $1.40 as they had hoped and really wanted, you know, they got $1.38, and that's still $3 higher. So like I said, in the Southern Plains, live cattle traded for $1.38. That's considered $3 higher from last week's market. And most of the Southern Plains didn't trade until Thursday and Friday. Texas traded on Thursday. Kansas waited until Friday to really trade it. And so I commend all of you feedlots that waited until later in the week to do so. Hats off to you. Way to work for the dollars that you earned. In the Northern Plains last week, dress cattle sold for $2.18 to $2.26, mostly $2.20 to $2.22. And that's considered $3 to $5 higher, my friends. But get a load of this. Last week's volume. Now remember, it was in the time frame between Christmas and the New Year, and so processing plants aren't running full speed. The market is trading, but traders are absent. No one's really engaged. Who knows what day it is? It's just that cumbersome time where nobody really knows what's going on, but the days are going about as they always do. Last week's volume totaled 93,132 head in the negotiated cash cattle market. That is very telling. You guys, the fact that packers were willing to chase cattle during the time of Christmas and the New Year, that aggressively tells me that they need cattle. And get a load of this, 71% of that volume was committed for the nearby delivery, and 29% of them were committed for the deferred delivery. So as I've mentioned a couple times before, as we move into the January of 2022 and look at the first quarter and then the second quarter, when we expect the fat cattle market to make its seasonal high for the year, we really need to watch how cattle are being committed. And so we talk about it each and every week here, the nearby committed cattle, the deferred committed cattle, and when those cattle are going to be scheduled and how that affects the cash cattle market. But my friends, pay attention to it, especially as we continue to enter into the weeks of 2022, because it'll affect how the rally is able to either gain momentum and gain steam and just become more robust and more aggressive, or how it's hindered and held back because packers are pushing more and more cattle to the deferred delivery, which hinders the upcoming week's cash cattle market. So I don't have a whole lot of details for you. Last week was just kind of an odd week, like I said, in between Christmas and the New Year, so there wasn't a whole lot that went on, but I'll go ahead and give you box beef prices throughout the week. Choice cuts averaged $265.03. That's up $2.89 throughout the week. Select cuts averaged $256.65, up $5.56, with a movement of 472 loads, and so that is encouraging. That's really exciting for the cash cattle market's rally. Hopefully packers are going to continue to support the cash cattle market, just simply because these box beef prices are clipping higher already in the new year, and so hopefully that'll help our market. Let's go ahead and talk about these carcass weights, you guys. For the week ending December 18th, 2021, steers averaged 924 pounds. That's 5 pounds lower than the previous week. Thankful to hear that. And heifers averaged 850 pounds. That was 1 pound lower from the previous week. But both steer and heifer carcass weights are 3 pounds higher than what they were a year ago. So you guys, as we're seeing these carcass weights be astronomically high and for historical trends and purposes, we need to be really careful, because it's telling that the market, that these weights are as high as they are. And you know what? I know that we've been seeing some pretty good fat cattle prices, but they're not necessarily just, you know, earth-shattering, absolutely prices in which make feedlots fall over because they don't know what they're going to do with all the money that they've earned. And so with corn prices starting to flirt with that $6 a bushel level, we have to be really careful with that. And so we need to keep these carcass weights in check and really monitor them in the weeks to come. So like I said, steers averaged last week 924 pounds and heifers average 850 pounds. We're going to go ahead and talk about some feeder cattle trends, and we're not going to get into prices just simply because there weren't feeder cattle that really traded. There was a few that traded later in the week last week, and they were, the reports that I saw, anywhere from mostly $3 to $6 higher, instances of $8 to $10 higher. The feeder cattle market is going to go bonkers most likely this week, depending on what corn does, if given the opportunity. So like I said, given that the feeder cattle market hasn't had a really strong test since before the week of Christmas, this market is just likely to be sought with so much attention, and order buyers are going to be anxious to get feeders bought, just simply because, you know what, they haven't had an opportunity to really dive into this market for now going on 3 weeks. And with the rally that the cash cattle market's having, and the fact that the April board, oh heck, as of last week, the April board was, you know, upwards of $1.45. Today, Monday, is trading at $1.44. You guys, that's exciting. And so these order buyers, they're going to the sale barns this week, and they're most likely going to go ahead and throw the coins down. Obviously, those heavier weight feeders are going to be sought with a little bit more aggression, most likely, than those lighter weight feeders, just simply because it's going to take less feed to get them to where they need to go. So the big hurdle that we're going to have to jump in regards to feeder cattle prices is, again, the corn market. That corn market's getting really close to tipping over of $6 a bushel. And so if it does, that'll obviously put a hindrance on the live cattle side of things, even though, as you know, they're pretty much done eating corn, but it negatively affects the morale of the market, and then obviously the feeder cattle market, because that's an input that they're going to have to consume and acquire. So I'm excited for the 2022 and the year ahead. We need to continue to pray for our friends and family. Give Mackenzie Johnson a message and a prayer while you're thinking about it, and don't forget to pray for rain. So ladies and gentlemen, Shaylee Stewart here with your Cattle Market News Tip Sheet, brought to you in part by DTN.